You're right, but this is the next book in my series, obviously. The next pages, sorry. So this is the first pages that we did, and I've now rubbed out all the lines. So I'll just show you what it looks like now. So there with all the lines rubbed out that we did previously. So we can go on to the next page. Well, the next page following on from this is the floating eyeballs on the left-hand side and giant vampire bats on the right-hand side. First of all, I would suggest that you need to do the floating eyeballs. This is obviously the writing. Again, I'm going to do this in the pencil that I normally use. Let's have a go. Oh, as you can see, I've already drawn three ball shapes on my page. That's just so I know where the eyeballs are going to go, because they're obviously a key part of this page. So, first bit I'm doing. Remember this one, writing this took me a couple of attempts last time. So, let's have a look. That looks too low. Sorry, bear with me 2 seconds, right? That's where one lot of writing's going to go. That's where the other lot of writing's going to go. I've got the red drawing, little floating eyeballs, red drawing. Little floating eyeballs. So technically, where's my rubber gone? I need floating to be about there. And then eyeballs, I'd say about. Yeah, be careful of your space, because there is a lot to get in this one. So you've got to have the red little writing there. Obviously, that's going to be about there, actually. A little bit of writing there. Another writing there. I don't know if you can really see that very well. I basically just draw myself a little graph, so you've got eyeballs, the little pictures, where words are going, etc. So I know what space I have to give myself. So let's go with the floating, the eyeball picture. These words are quite long, or longer than I would normally do, like an F and an L and stuff like that. So. I will thicken these up when I do it in pen. I'm just going to do pencil first.
So that bit's done. Okay, okay. So that needs to start about where the L is. Yay.
So that's what that looks like at the moment. So you've got floating eyeballs. That's about where you want it to be on the page. I am going to go over that with one of these. It's quite a nice... you can put the right one. There's so many of these down things. That's a bit better. It's got quite a nice... I can see that very well. Quite a nice tip to it. So this... That seems to be a little bit thick, but not majorly. Try one of the other ones actually. case you're wondering why I'm doing it this way as well, it's literally because if I do it this way, my hands aren't leaning over, which would then smudge it. And normally you don't even realise you're smudging it as you're doing it, and until it's too late. First bit, so that's just the title. Right, the next bit I'm going to do is I'm going to actually do the eyeballs itself, because that's the main part of the page. Do it that way. I move a bit closer. Alright, so you have three eyeballs. You've got one looking this way, and you've got one looking this way, one dead center. So, work eyeball to eyeball. Such a weird thing to say, but. Draw your circles first, work eyeball to eyeball, and they're going to be messy because they're meant to be messy, but all this particular picture is. So first of all, I always draw what I would consider like the retinal, so the middle of the eye. So this one has got the black part of the eye. And you've got on the outside. And a few little lines. Yeah, the middle. Obviously you've got all the veins on it as well. You can see that. I'm leaning on this now, so just be careful as well. that's my first eyeball. So I'm going to go for this one next. I am leaving all the shade in until the end, apart from like the colouring in part where I'm like, where it's pretty dark. So just so you know. So that is that eye done. I put on the shade in. What I'm going to do is I'm going to do the bits that are attaching the eyes first. not as big as that, actually. This one's just got quite a lot of light veins. It's got no actual lines in the middle bit here. It's got quite a few little veins. So that's pretty much all the eyeballs done, apart from, obviously, the shading now. The shading is quite important. If you see, look at the picture, there's quite a lot of hatching and cross-hatching in it. Hatching is, for anyone that doesn't know, where am I here, is just lines. Cross-hatching is when you double over those lines. So they kind of look like that. That's just for anyone that doesn't know. Isn't familiar with that term. So we're now gonna put all of the shading into it. So this is on the outside and the inside of the eyeball. So we're gonna start with this one. So we've got cross hatching at the top of this eyeball. Side here. Hatching in this is actually going around in an oval shape just to follow the shape of the eyeball. Okay, so just make sure you do lines with a little bit of curve to them as you do them. You might need to actually go over once you've done some of the hatching with some of your veins, just to make sure you can, you know, still see that they're there. That hatching comes through there. Right, this bit's a lot more messy inside. So this bit, I've just done a few lines. It's supposed to look veiny, I guess. So this bit here is just hatching. Same. just this bit. We've got one of the little veins around this side. Touching here. So that is my eyeballs done, and that's what the finished picture looks like. Obviously, that way up. I just move my thing out of the way. So that is the first part of the page. Obviously, the drawings in this one are the ones that take quite a while. There are some pages that are just very easy, and others, unfortunately, aren't. So, now what I am going to do is rub out these squares. Sorry, pen in my mouth. Rub out these squares up here. Because I'm going to be doing stuff in them now. I just want it to be easier. Now what I'm going to do is the rest of the floating eyeball page. So, first of all, top left corner, you've got some red drawings. I don't normally use a trace for these because they're quite small. So, first one is a big circle, or a bigger circle. Sorry, I'm using this pen. Quite a nice little nib to it again. It's got a circle inside. Once you've done the eyeballs to this page, the rest of the page will come together quite quickly. So, little squiggle, and then a line, and a dot. You've then got a circle, a triangle in the middle, circle, middle. So that's that one done. I'm going to use a pen if I can find it. Right, top right hand corner, you've got some eyeballs. I'm going to use the pen that I write with, because they're only thinly based, so best. So you need to have three eyeballs. You need to make them look like that they are moving, like jiggling about kind of thing. So that is the top of the page, completely done now. Right, the next one I'll do is get my red pen again. And we're going underneath here, and we're going to do kind of like the red text underneath. So it's basically three E's. Wiggly line. An E facing downwards. Kind of bigger E facing upwards. And a dot. Kind of a big W with little extra bits. Dot and a circle. That comes out a bit more. And you've got an E facing down. E facing the wrong way. And E facing up. Yay! Right. So that is the text for that bit. I will show you this all up the right way when I've finished it. Right, just so I know if I've got enough space. Are they watching me in this bit here? So it's pretty much just, it's all lowercase as well. I think it actually needs to be closer. Are they watching me? It's all meant to be joined up. I'm going to do that in 2 seconds because I want to do this red piece first. For this red one, though, you are going to need a ruler because there's some particular straight lines in this. Ew. Start off with one big circle. Inside that, do a small circle, smaller circle. And then you need a smaller circle in the middle. A little line coming out from there.
What? Can I have four of your angles? No, not them ones. This one, if you want. Look.
Yeah, if you want. You need to do a squiggly line in here. Like this. This is where you're going to need your ruler, because you're going to need to do a line coming from the top of the squiggly line, going up. Like so. And do a line coming off of that. Make this into a bit of an E. With points on the top. So two jagged lines on this one. A little triangle. Two jagged lines on this end, and a triangle with a circle and a dot in the middle. Triangle over here with a dot in the middle. Right. And on this end, you're going to need a squiggly line that comes away with a full stop at the end. You need your ruler again. You need to do a line. Comes down. Right. And you do an E at this end again. With dots on the ends. This bit is in between this. The lines here, you do a T with dots at the end. Little triangle over here, and our three jagged lines. So, I'm going to go over this bit first. I'm going over it with this one. That is that part of the page. So now we're going to go on to the important part, which is I'm going to do the first bit of writing, which is here. So this is, you have to write quite small. So it says,